ain't no gunshots, but they getting.
Hey, what's up, you guys? It's Craft Farms again, back with another video. Today we are going to be back on Dad's farm, doing some more work. As you can see, it's getting late at night. Come on, truck, slow down. We have finished chopping field 3, and we're starting on field 4 here. If we tab over to this guy here, you can see we have one bunker that is completely full. And then this one here has 491,956 liters in it. These bunkers hold 600,000 total. So once we do that, we'll have just under 1.2 million liters just about. It's going to take about one more semi-truck load to fill this bunker. Will be just about full. I'm undecided at this second if I'm gonna just like dump piles of silage along here or chaff and then use it later. I don't think I'm going to. We're gonna fill the truck up, and then that's gonna be the end of this pile of the silage. We filled up the fifth Meridian bin, so we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bins full. So now we're just hauling to the elevator. So far we have 1,299,335 liters of wheat that we've harvested so far. Once we figure out, once we finish our harvest, as you can see, we're getting close. Then I'll calculate how much wheat we got, or how many bushels of wheat we got, and then I'll figure out how many bushels an acre we averaged, and stuff like that. Our truck is 74% full, which is good. Alright, so now we're going to get continuing on here. So our truck here is just about full, we're half full. I definitely hate farming at night because it lags a lot more because of all the lights and crap that are on and whatnot, and that's the thing I do not like about it. Now comes the fun part of all these turns and stuff. So yeah, we're going to just fill up this trailer and then go from there. Then we will take our chopper back to the farm and wash it off, and then tell the dealer that it's ready to be picked up. And then we'll return our truck as well. And then we will compact our pit and then return our tractor as well. Okay, come on there. First place, slow down. Yeah, we're running some pretty poor frames right now. I think it's mainly because of this stupid chopper with its lights on. But generally at night it also lags more, which really sucks. But what can you do? And the combine just filled up again. So then once the grain cart empties the combine, we'll get it over to the truck, and then we'll have a full truckload again, and then we can haul it to the co-op. Alright, so let's shut this guy down. That guy unloading. Pop back over here. So we're running a little better now with that chopper lights with its lights off. So yeah, we will have to repair our equipment as well before we return it. Or actually, maybe we won't. We'll just take the extra charge for them repairing it. So we'll be returning everything besides our grain cart. Our grain cart we'll be keeping. So now we'll just stop that guy there. Here, and we'll have plenty of silage to last us quite a while, so we should not have to do silage for quite some time. I hope, anyways. This silage should last us quite a while, I would assume. So that's what we're going off of. Got a little pile started right there. Yeah, this will be fairly full. It's not going to be 100%, but I don't want to fill the trailer and then have a bunch of extra or anything like that. So we're just going to empty this and call it good. So I'll pull this guy off to the side here. And actually, we really won't wash our... Now we won't wash our chopper, we'll just let them wash it and pay them a little bit of extra cash, I guess. Yeah, this big case tractor gets this done pretty dang well. So I think with our... I'm going to revisit our list of beef equipment to buy, and we can take a chopper and truck off of there and tractor for compacting silage, because we will not need to do silage for quite some time, like I said. And if we do end up needing to do silage again, what we can do is just rent a truck and chopper again. So really not that worried about it. We'll worry about it when that time comes. So yeah, we should be about done with the wheat in this episode. Very nearly, if we aren't. We're going to tell this guy to... Oh, he's going to drive anyways because he's going to fill up. Alright. So we got 3 passes left. We won't worry about the combine doing that 4th pass. We're going to shut our straw swath off. I should have done that a long time ago, but... Oh well. Now we're going to chop this. Okay, there we go. Back to this guy. And finish off the compacting. So yeah, we averaged a bin a field. Actually, more like a bin and a quarter a field. I mean, we got quite a bit, and we'll find out here in a little bit what our final count is. This video might end up being longer than a half hour, because I'm not gonna just like cut it short and make you guys wait until Saturday's video to figure out what happens with that, with the wheat. I'm going to show that in this video. And then once I finish recording this video, what I'm going to do is get all of our equipment. Actually, we'll take the equipment back to the yard in this video yet. This video will end once all of our equipment is parked and put away and whatnot. And then I'm going to turn the time scale up just to 120. And then while the time speeds up, I'm going to work on editing some pictures, because I have quite a lot of pictures built up already. Again, that I need to edit and get put in my Dropbox. And then, well, it does that, then I'll do those, and then probably, you know, by the time I'm done, it should be close to the time. Well, actually, I probably don't want to do that because I might end up taking a while. Well, what I'm going to do is we'll get the equipment to, you know, all parked in the yard and whatnot, and then I'll pause, I'll, you know, go to the escape menu on the game, and I'll go to the pause menu and then jeez, I lost my train of thought. And then I'll edit my pictures, and then I'll come back and I will fast forward time to the next day, and so our soybeans are ready, and then I'll record a video right away where we will be working on soybeans, and that'll be your Saturday video. Alright, so we got another 49,334. I will truck over to the co-op elevator, and we will drop this load off. Yeah, we've had a very great wheat harvest. Hopefully our beans and corn run just as well. I think what we'll probably do is leave 5 bins for the corn, and then, you know, we'll see how many bins we fill with the beans, and if we fill quite a lot, we'll make sure that we leave 5 empty for the corn, and then any beans that we have left, you know, if we fill all but 5 bins, any beans we have left, we will haul to town, to wherever they're most expensive, or most well-paying. And then, you know, with corn, we'll fill those bins, and then, or we'll start off, you know, we'll just kind of see how everything goes, really. And we'll make our plans then. And our combine is full again. Our grain cart's being completely stupid again. I hate that. It's like the 4th time I've dealt with that today. We got 2 passes left, and then our combine is done for the season. 13 hours it has taken so far to combine all of our wheat. That is a lot of time. But in real life, that's no time at all. That's just, you know, that's one day, not even a full harvest day. But in game, that is a long time. That's 13 hours of real time. I've put probably... Boy, I don't know. I put a lot of time into this map. Quite a lot. So our green card is full, so we need to book it back to the field and get him unloaded so we can get back to chasing the combine. Now there's all 330 of our bales, which we will hopefully be able to afford equipment to stack soon. Our truck's getting dirty. Our hopper is getting dirty as well. The truck and trailer haven't done a whole lot of driving. Yeah, the truck's got 12 and a half hours on it, but it most of its time has been spent just sitting. You know, it doesn't spend much time to get between the auger and the field. It spends a lot of time just sitting there waiting for it to get filled up from the grain cart, and then a lot of time spent just sitting there waiting for it to empty into the auger. So, but we've had a successful harvest so far. Like I said, our wheat has done very, very well. I think we'll get one more trailer out of this, because if our combine fills, if the combine fills, it'll fill the truck with what's, you know, if with whatever the combine holds. I think it's 12,000 something, 12 and a half thousand, I think is what it holds. With the 12 and a half that it holds, it'll fill the rest of the truck from whatever, you know, the grain cart doesn't put in. So we'll get one more truckload and then we'll have a little bit left. And we need to go someplace else. Someplace that's not quite so laggy. Okay, so what we're gonna do, we're gonna get this brought up. Liters to bushels. And we'll get our calculator opened up here. And then we will, that way we're ready. We still got 11 minutes, so might be a normal length video. So green cart's just about empty, and he'll come over and unload the combine one last time, because I doubt the combine's gonna fill up again going on that little strip. Highly doubt it. Let's actually jump to this guy here and let's get his field speed turned up so that way he gets to that combine fast. Hopefully he goes to the combine right away. Yep. So the rest of this straw will all just go under with soil mod. And it'll be fertilizer, so we'll have strips of fertilizer. It'll just go under and act as fertilizer. There you can see there was a big spot where Courseplay kept screwing up. It got really annoying. So we'll start slowing this guy down. Back into the combine here and just kind of run along with him. So yeah, we'll just sit in the combine for a little bit, since we have nothing else to do. What we will be doing when we take all the equipment to the yard is we'll be repairing everything and refueling everything, so that way it's all topped off and all fixed up for soybeans. The combine here has 5% damage overall. The grain cart here has 14 overall. The truck here has, holy smokes, that's a lot of damage. That's 38% damage on it overall. Our Farm King has 1%, so that's no biggie. I ain't even gonna worry about that. So we're gonna send the driver home, because we won't need to unload the combine again, and that will top off the truck. And then we're gonna hit M and turn on our animated chopper here. Hop on over to the grain cart here, and we'll get him going fast again. I really hate when his speed wobbles. That's really annoying. Even does it going slow. We're just going to stop this driver, and we are going to run this ourselves and get this put in the grain cart. We're going to shut our lights off because they are making the game lag. We're going to shut our lights off here as well. Now I got to watch this combine, because when he gets to the end, he's going to try and turn around. Don't want that. Actually, we'll just stop the driver here, and we will finish off this little bit ourselves. Get a screenshot of our last little bit of wheat. Holy smokes. This actually got filled up quite a lot from just that little bit. That's amazing. Guess I won't complain. Hopefully it doesn't fill up. We're gonna be close. So our truck is full. We still got 8% in the grain cart. Yeah, we're gonna run out of space in the combine here. Be nice if you could, you know, go a little over like you can in real life. In real life, you can kind of push it a little bit longer, but... Alright, so let's get this guy going here. We'll head on over to the combine and then unload it. And then we'll finish off our little section there. It is going to be annoying having all the bins full, because our glance will come down quite a ways. We have 29 bins, so if we fill all of them, that's 29 things showing up there. It's going to look a little something like that. It's going to be quite the thing. This guy unloaded here. we'll just kind of whip around here and pick up a couple of these little spots here, this one anyways, since it's in our path. We'll go over here and we'll empty the combine out, and then that'll be a wrap for, oops. Yeah, you guys didn't see that. Alright, and that's a wrap. So, we got a full truck. So, we gotta add another 49,334 to that. And then, up to this guy, we have 16,562. 1,414,000. $565,000. Wow. So we'll say we have 40,142 bushels. I'll just kind of round that. So we have 142. That'll be divided by. Okay, so now we can clear this. One is 14.29, 18.32, 17.87, and 18.04, for a total of 68.52 hectares. Or 169 acres. So I'll take this and divide it by 169.3. So we got 237 bushels an acre, which is not bad. We're going to go to Google Sheets here. And we'll create a new one. Dad's farm harvest yields. Wheat. Oops. We'll put crop. Total of liters. Total of bushels. Total hectares, total acres, bushels per acre. So we have wheat, we have this. We said this was 40,142. Our total hectares was 68.52. Our total acres was 169.3. Our bushels per acre was 237.1. There we go. Awesome. So let that save. There we go. We'll clear that out. We'll stop that. Close that. Alright, so we can clear that, shut that off. And we'll hop to our truck here. And we'll haul this load to the elevator. And then come back and empty the grain cart. Take that to the elevator as well, and get everything parked up and get ready for beans. Everything is going to go park in the yard. We're not going to leave it out by the field or anything. Because I do have to also do course recordings and all that stuff. So I'll have to spend some time sitting in the combine recording field courses. So that way we can just roll along with the harvest. Don't have to worry about, you know, okay, we finished this field. Time to record course for this field. Get it all set up, saved, all that stuff. Yeah, really awesome wheat harvest. I would fill four bins and a partial on my map. Well, for Tempik anyways, I just talked to my papa here yesterday. Today is Wednesday, so I talked to him on Tuesday. And I got numbers from him. I got the capacity of the bins at Tempik and the elevator at Tempik, and then the length and width of the Quonset at Tempik as well. The bins are 10,000 bushel bins, but he said they only hold 9,000 because of the flooring that he has in it. That allows, I think he said heat, because he's got heated bins, I think he said. You know, they have a different flooring in them also to allow the air to come in from the fans and then for heat. And so he said that you can only put about 9,000 in them. He said, but just put them down as 10,000. And then he said the elevator is 20,000 bushels. And we're just going to cut through here. And then he said the Quonset right next to the elevator is 120 feet long, I think he said, 120 or 140. It's 120 feet long and 40 feet wide. So it's pretty dang nice Quonset. I just about have the Quonset finished. All I gotta do is model up the doors for it, and then that will be done. I have it AO baked and ready for export to Giants Editor. I have to fix a slight issue that I have on it, but other than that, nothing major. So we'll get this guy folded up, we'll get our header folded up, and then we'll head on back to the farm with this guy. We'll pull up next to the fuel trailer and get it fueled up and fixed up, and then we'll head on into the farm. We got a pretty fair load in our truck again. 30%, 2%, that's not bad. I don't know what this is showing that's 78% full. I suppose it's the fuel trailer here. Yeah, it's showing the fill level on the fuel trailer. I don't know why I didn't think of that. Alright, so let's get backed up to it here. Go, there's the fuel trigger, and if we hop into it, I'll hit prepare. All right, our combine's ready to go, our truck is ready to go again, and we got 33%. And we'll again cut across here, and then we'll cut through again and go straight over to the road to fill up and fix up. See, I got the bins done for the map. I took the twister bins that were released on American Eagle's modding. They were pretty close. They were just a little over 10,000 bushel bins. So I took them and redid a few things on it. Added some things to it to make it look like the bins from my papa's farm. And then changed the capacity. I did the bushels to liters conversion and put in 10,000 bushels, and then took the liters and rounded it up just up or down, whatever it was. I rounded it just a little bit, And then I inputted that in and tested it in-game to make sure that it worked and all that, and it did. Got a bin fan on it, replicating the real-life bin fan and all that good stuff. So once I get ready to put it on the map, I'll put it in the map, and then I'll set it just above the ground, because it will, you know, if I set it in the ground, because the bins are purchasable, you know, the way that I'll set that up is that you, when you start the game, you own all of the bins and stuff already. So, like, you know, you own them and you're paying maintenance on them, and, you know, but they spawn in the point where they need to be, is basically what they do. Oops, all right, that's fixed up. Get this guy, tarp him, and take him back to the farm. Or back to the truck, I guess. Get him fueled up and fixed up. And we'll put more fuel in our fuel trailer once we get everything back to the yard. So that way everything is full of fuel, everything's fully repaired and ready to rock and roll once we get started on soybeans. So yeah, this is your Thursday video. You guys will be seeing it Thursday. So probably, I don't know if I'll probably end up doing it here in a little while. I'll be recording your Saturday video. And then I'll be ahead on videos for a while, and I'll, you know, do a little bit of soybean harvesting off camera, and then just sit and work on my map, hardcore. I might do some live streams, I'm not sure at this point what I'll do. I'll tarp this guy as well, and we'll get him on follow me mod behind the combine. Get him at 15. We don't need to put a whole lot of fuel in our truck. That is, does have quite a fair amount of fuel in it. So we'll wait for our truck to finish fueling. So we're going to have to get him on follow me. We'll get this guy on follow me as well. And then we'll get this guy going on follow me mod as well. I don't know what it is about this truck, but damage mod does not like it at all. See, right there, all I did was kind of gun it a little bit, and I got 2% damage on the truck and 3% on... now I have 5 and 6. Yeah, it's ridiculous. I'll have to be repairing my pickup again. You can see we got some lights going. Let's get some beacons and hazards going as well. And we'll get this convoy to the farm. There we go. Get our screenshot there. Boy, this is going to be a tight fit. Actually gonna shut our lights off because that's making me lag quite a bit. But it's gonna be kind of sketchy getting into the farm here. correctly. Hopefully our semi doesn't hit that pole with the trailer. That would suck. Ooh, he cleared it. Good. Thank God. And we have a header trailer sitting here, don't we? Yeah. Let's see. We're going to skim our header trailer. Yes, we are. My goodness. Right, we'll get all that shut off now. And, alright, we can stop that guy. Switch to our header so that way we can drop the header. Alright, we'll park this guy here. Hop in our grain cart. Stop his followers. And our grain cart got damaged. Go figure. Gotta love that. Oh well, we'll just repair it again, I guess. How badly damaged? Holy smokes. Jeez. Yeah, this guy got damaged. This guy damaged? Yes, he is. The joys of using damage mod and also using crazy equipment are... There. Is our truck repaired? Now it is. So the next video should have much, much better frame rate. It shouldn't... There's our truck, tractor, trailer, grain cart. It shouldn't be at all as laggy in the next video, with it being daylight. At least I hope, anyways. So we can squeeze through here. Alright, we'll hop in our truck here and get him parked, and then that'll be all for this video. So, thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed the video, hit that thumbs up button. If you're new to the channel, welcome to the channel. Make sure to hit that subscribe button, and make sure you turn on the post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. My video schedule is Tuesdays and Thursdays at 4 p.m. Central Time, Saturdays at noon Central. And that will be changing very soon as we start incorporating more games into the channel. Check out down below in the description for links to my social medias, my mod site, and other cool YouTube channels to check out. On my mod site is version 2 of the small stack mover, version 2 of the large stack mover, and also that fuel trailer. I just released those yesterday, so make sure you go check those out as well. And go get them downloaded. Take me in some pictures of them, whether it's on Google Plus, Craft Farms on there. You can put them on my Facebook page, Craft Farms, or put them on Instagram and tag me in them, or send them to me in a DM. I am craft_farms on there. All my social media links are down below, including Flickr. So thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys next time.